What's up, guys? I am at home right now in my living room. Got all my couch stuff pushed over there. We're going to be going over a Tabata workout. So this is something you guys can do at home. It's primarily abs and then also going to be HIIT. So basically, we're going to be doing a high intensity movement for 45 seconds, resting for 15 seconds, and then jumping into a ab movement for 45 seconds, resting. We're going to be doing that. This is basically going to take you 10 minutes. We're then going to throw a little bonus round at you guys. So total is going to be 12 minutes. You can go through it 2 or 3 times if you want to, if it's not enough, and go 24 or 36 minutes. So it's going to be a lot of work if you do that. So we're just going to go through one round. It's going to be a total of 12 minutes, always working for 45 seconds, resting for 15. So if you have a timer or a Tabata app, I suggest using one of those. The reason I like these workouts is because it gives us an opportunity to target abs. And we're going to be doing different workouts. We're going to be making sure that we do some twisting. We're going to be targeting some lower abs, some obliques. So basically making sure that we're working the abs from all different angles. And we're going to keep that heart rate elevated, which means we're going to be burning more calories, more fat in the process. This is a fun way to train abs because it's high intensity. Mentally, you're always checked into it. So without further ado, let's jump into the first exercise. All right, guys, first exercise is just gonna be a heel tap, bringing the knees up. Let's go. Let's go. Right here. You can either go fast, back and forth. Again, we got 45 seconds, or you can go high knees. You wanna just touch the knees. I like touching those heels. Definitely gonna mean my knees are coming all the way up. You can go back and forth if you want to, or if you just need to be here, you can go here. Whatever you can, get it done. Speed is up. Keep it working. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good. Woo-wee! Next up, got a little rest period, and then we're gonna be doing on our back, side to side heel touches here. So this is gonna be working our obliques here. Let's jump into this action. Notice my upper back is off the mat at all times. Touching those heels each time. Good. If you need to stop and rest, take only what you need and then get back at it. This workout is going to be all about what you put into it. Good. Keep it going. Keep it going. Start burning, using all sorts of different ab muscles there. Transverse abs, obliques. Time. 15 seconds rest. Everything that we're doing here, guys, making sure we're using good form. Don't get sloppy. If we're doing a core movement, brace that core. Next up, ground overhead touches. Here, pop it up. So it's a squat, tap and go up. This is ensuring that we get all the way down, all the way up. Again, we have the ab movement, and then we have really a movement that's just going to be designed to get our heart rate through the roof. And if you want, you can speed these up, you can jump higher, that's up to you. Even if you're just here, that's fine too. All the way down, all the way up. This is about you and yourself today. Pushing yourself, woo! Legs are burning. 2, 1. 15 seconds rest. We're gonna be back on our back for our next ab movement, which is gonna be flutter kicks. Hands underneath. And I'm just gonna be right here. 12 inches off with my feet, keeping my legs straight. My lower back pressed into the mat. I'm not arching my back. Lower back is pressed into that mat. Shoulder breathing. Good work. 10 minutes can have a profound effect on your day. If you do this at the beginning of your day, it's gonna set you on a positive path for the rest of the day. Let's go, keep it up. If you're like me, maybe you'll switch it. Start going scissor, one over the other. Try not to let those feet touch the ground. Two, one, time. 15 seconds, we're back on our feet. I'm already sweating. We got walkouts. Walkout's gonna look like this. Slight bend in the knee, walk it out, plank position, walk it back, stand up. Plank position, stand up. We're recruiting hamstrings here, lower back, abs, a little bit of shoulders here. Good. Stand it up. Anytime we're bending over like this, we're also making it harder for ourselves to get deep breath. The reason they tell you always to stand up when you're having a hard time breathing, it's the easiest way to get air into those lungs. We start putting in a position like this, it's harder to breathe. Last one. Good work. This is about where I want my heart rate at right now. It's jacked, it's elevated, it's hard for me to talk to you. That's what I want. Next up, alternating toe touches. Get nice and tall, touch that leg. Nice and tall, touch that leg. If you wanna make it a little bit harder, don't come all the way back down, stay right here. Woo! A little bit of hip flexor on this one, as well as abs. Woo-wee! Burning off all that quarantine snacking. Let's go. Two, one, woo-wee! Yes, sir, 15 seconds. It's gonna come awful fast. All right, moving on to the next one here. Gonna be your basic jumping jack right here. I think in the UK and Australia, they call them star jacks. You can go here, here. I prefer to go up and over the head. 45 seconds here. We can pick it up, pick that speed up, we can clap. This is our heart rate getter. Go after it right now. Keep it going. Keep it going. It's actually a good little shoulder pump too. Come on now. Five, four, three, two, one. Shake everything out. We'll be on our mat. You can see pretty much we're alternating in the standing position and on our mat. Reverse crunch. Hands go underneath our butt again, knees to the chest. So it's kind of like the leg raise. Those knees come all the way up. If you want, you can throw a leg lift into it. Knee to the chest, and then up. I'm gonna stick right here. Two, one, ooh! Definitely great for those lower abs. Now, we got body drops. Body drops, gonna be real simple. Kind of an easier movement compared to a burpee, but similar idea. Move it here, hand goes down, press back up, hand comes up. Again, you decide what you want your push-up to look like. It might be right here. It might be right here. That's just fine. If you need to go to your knees, go to your knees. But don't start going down until that hand goes down. You can speed it up. Good work. Last one. That's our heart rate part. Next up, we got our plank position, hips side to side. Plank position right here. You can see I'm not sagging and I'm not up in the air. Could be right here, controlling that side to side. I don't want to see this. We're not resting here. We're just going nice and steady, side to side. Keep it going. At any time if you need to, come back to this plank position right here. Keep it going. Last round before our bonus. Three, two, one. Ooh. Well, I was a little late with the time there. Oh, good work. Give yourself now a minute rest. Meet me back here. We got one bonus round.
A few moments later.
Bonus round, gave you a minute rest. What we got now, bear crawls for 45 seconds, rest for 15, and then candlestick roll-ups. This will give you 12 minutes of high intensity and abs here. Again, if you're feeling frisky, do another round of it to give you 24 minutes. If you're feeling real crazy, do 36 minutes. That'd be three rounds. So let's jump into it. Bear crawls, get in that bear crawl position. We did these almost every single day on Biggest Loser. Great overall workout for the body. It's gonna target legs, back, shoulders, triceps. Keep it going. That backwards bear crawl, that's rough. Just keep moving. Whatever you gotta do. I'd always tell everyone on the Biggest Loser, if you keep moving, you're winning. Just keep moving. It's gonna get tough, just move. Even if it means crawling on your hands and knees. Two, one, time. Shoulders are burning. Candlestick roll-ups. Get ready for it. It's coming at you. Start these out. Nice tall position. Two, one, here. You might have to take a step back like that. Definitely generating a lot of force in the abs. You're nice and tired right now. You want to get lazy, but you can't on this one. Last one. That is 12 minutes. Your abs will be on fire. Your heart rate's gonna be jacked. If you need to, take a few minutes and do another round. Maybe do it later on today. When you're feeling your breathing start to get really intact, so when you stand up, open up that airway. Pat yourself on the back. That's a tough 12 minute workout. Let me know how many rounds you do. I'm gonna do one more later on today out in that sun. Thank you guys, make sure you subscribe. Let me know what kind of bodyweight workouts you wanna see next time. We'll see you soon.